Hi, farmers. I hope that you've been doing okay. Mine has been a good time all the way since the day that we left. I left you in sometimes in May, and it's been a good time in a learning moment, trying to make things better for us all. So we've been learning so many tips concerning agribusinesses, what we're doing in our farms and how we can improve our agribusinesses. And the journey is just getting better and it has just begun. So first of all, I want to make an apology to all of you because I left without saying where I was going and I was not posting. I was not busy on the channel. So I want to say sorry. So forgive me for that. I was out there trying to learn and getting new information for us to be able to improve our agribusinesses. So today, I just wanted to say I'm sorry and also to welcome you back to this channel. For those of you that have subscribed during the time that I've not been posting, I really thank you. Thank you so much for joining this family. Here we talk about our farming, we talk about how to improve our agribusinesses so that we can make a profit out of our farming practices at the end of the day. One thing that I am going to be insisting on, it is preparation and planning. So one of the things that we're going to be doing is to build our farming practices. I'm going to be referring to my notes here because I'm not going to play the genius here. No, I'm not a genius, so I don't have everything in my head. I have written it down so that it can be prepared in a well, and I can also give you something of quality, something that is going to help you. So much of our content has been on crop production, but there is something that we've been forgetting, the business perspective of our agribusinesses. So from now henceforth, we shall be talking more about how to improve our crop production and also how to improve it in the business perspective so that we can be able to make profits out of what we are going to be doing and so that we can be able to grow. For that to happen, we need to have proper planning. This is something that I am currently applying, but I have seen it working for me since May. Since May, and we are now in the start of July. So since May up to now, I've seen so much improvement because of planning and preparing what I am doing for the business. And I want us to work in that perspective. And this does not mean that you're not going to put any work. By the way, this is a lot of work and it is a lot of dedication. So you have to be disciplined. You have to be willing to put in the work, grow, willing to learn and willing to put effort into, you know, growing yourself, growing your farm, and generally growing even the people around us. We are going to be learning the farming practices that are going to improve our agribusiness. That is equipping ourselves with the entrepreneurial skills that we need for our agribusinesses to improve. We're also going to learn the benefits associated with the growth and what we can do to achieve this growth. I give you an example. Most of the farmers, or most of us, you will find that we are operating as a business, yes, but our businesses are not registered. And we are like, we do not want to register our businesses because we do not want to be paying taxes. Yes, that is a downside to the profits, but in the long run, it is going to increase your profits because, one, you can sell your share capital to an investor and therefore you will be raising money towards the growth of your business. Secondly, it is generally considered as a separate entity. So your shares in the business and you yourself as a person, you are two different things. That way, if in case your business goes into some, you know what happens with businesses, sometimes you engage in this. I'll give an example with a construction business. For example, if you are in the construction industry, you are building a roof and then that roof, it falls off, you know, immediately or sometimes after you're done building. If you're doing it as a sole proprietor, it will be your responsibility for you to repair and it might incur even your assets, your private assets, that which you didn't even buy with the business money. So for you to prevent such risks, it is best that you register your business such that it is going to be the company that is going to be responsible for the damage that has occurred. That way, for example, if you're giving people food and probably by chance or by, I don't know, you know, risks happen. So if in case people get poisoned, you will not be responsible as a person, but the business is going to be responsible for that. So that is one of the benefits of registering your business, your agribusiness, so that you can be considered as a separate entity. So we are going to be talking more about how we can do agriculture as agribusiness. Today I also want to give a shout out to Mokaya. Yes, he's a farmer and he's done managu farming. So here is what he's been doing. He has planted his managu and they are doing well. Soon he shall be selling them. Probably he has started selling them because he sent me this video sometime back. And I'm very happy and inspired to keep doing this, you know, to keep doing things that are going to encourage us to do better, to improve our farming practices and to improve our income in the long run. Okay. Yes. One more thing that I wanted to talk about today is the managus that we planted. If you remember this video here, we planted the managus at 27th April. And since then, the managus have not done well. The one that I showed you how to do a seed bed. But it is not the seeds that were the problem. It is the location that I selected to plant the managus. So here is how they've been looking like. They have really refused to grow. I have really begged these managus to grow. But technically, it's like they just don't want to grow. However, we planted after 10 days. Was it after 10 days? May 10th from April 27th. So that's around 17 days. We planted more managus in a different location. And this is how they have been doing. We have transplanted most of the managus, actually. And this is how they have also been doing. We also transplanted others yesterday. And the process is continuing because the managus are quite a bit. But I love the germination and the way they have been developing. And soon, I'm expecting to have the harvesting period. Probably next month, August. Yes, after a good watering. Because currently it's not raining, so we are entirely depending on the rains. So that is it, guys. I just wanted to update you on what we're going to be doing these coming weeks, in the month of July, August, September going forward. My emphasis is on planning. You need to plan, or we need to plan how we're doing our agribusinesses. It is not just about growing the crops. If you are this for commercial purposes, we have also to consider the business perspective about this. Secondly, we also need to consider who we are dealing with, the teams that you are building, and understanding the market. So we're going to be learning this in the next few days, but we will start with the passion fruit video. I promised you that I'm going to be talking about the pruning, the fertilizer application. So that is what I'm going to do after this. And thank you so much for subscribing, for coming to join the family, for being part of this. And I hope that we shall make a good community out of this, and we shall benefit from our farming practices. Until next time, guys, bye-bye. Remember to subscribe, like, comment, and share. Okay? Good. Take 1 second and hit that subscribe button. It is that red button down here. Yeah, it should be down here. Hit that subscribe button and you will be joining this family. You will be part of what we are doing. You will benefit from every information that I give out there. And remember to also hit the notification bell so that each time that I upload, you have the videos and then you can watch it as soon as I upload. For those of you who watch, for those of you who've been liking, for those of you who leave me comments, thank you so much. And I try my best, by the way, to reply to all of your comments. If I have not replied to any of your comments, I'm really sorry. Probably it missed me or I read and overlooked it. You can just comment again so that I can get a notification and I will be up for it. So guys, thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe, like, share, comment, share with your friends who are farmers, who want to grow their agribusinesses and who also want to join this industry. And until next time, bye-bye.